Hey guys, it's Chris from Macombu, and I'm here with the Sony Xperia X. This is the boxed UK version of Sony's new Xperia X, basically one of its new flagship phones for 2016. Looks like it could be set to replace the Z series. I've already had a good play with that out in Tokyo, so check out some of our videos from that if you haven't seen them yet. But we thought that since we've got the final retail model in, we'd give you a quick look at that as well, especially since the box is rather sexy. So as you can see, your typical sort of box size and shape and everything, nice and white and crisp on the front and the sides and the back. But once you open it up, you start to get a bit of that unified design come through. This is one of sort of Sony's big new design features on the Xperia X series. You can see all this lovely splashes of color on the sides, and that's set to mirror basically the different designs and the desktops of the new Xperia X series. So right here we've got the sexy sort of silver and white version. So that looks very nice. Let's just peel off some of the wrapping. As you can see, it's not a massive departure from your typical Sony design, the likes of the Xperia Z series and the rest. Still nice, sort of rectangular with these little curved edges, just like the Z5 and the Zs before it. And of course you get the nice fingerprint sensor on the side there, that's made a leap over from the Z5. Nice and flat, and you see just slight indentation with the edge there, and that should fit comfortably under the thumb when you're using the phone. So you just pull it out of your pocket and immediately you're straight into your desktops. You also get camera shutter button there, volume buttons. If you turn onto this edge, gets a little flap. And if you prize that open, that's where your memory cards and your SIM card go. They just sit in there, and that seals up nice and tight. Unfortunately, it's not water resistant, the Xperia X. That's that privilege is saved for the Xperia X Performance, which won't be officially making it to the UK via Sony, but it will be available in some stores potentially, if Sony gets its back together, because we really like the look of that phone. Old school USB on the bottom there, not Type-C unfortunately. And then on the back, you get this nice sort of textured finish. It's actually more of a metallic finish this time, rather than the sort of the glass finish of the Xperia Z5. So hopefully that should be a lot more solid, because our Z5 unfortunately cracked quite quickly. And then there's a nice plastic edging as well. So all fits together very nicely. It all feels very well put together, very solid indeed. Don't want to smash it too hard, obviously, before we even get started. Let's see if it's got any juice in it. It does, because I just felt a little vibration. Hooray! So while that's just booting up, we'll just take a quick look in the rest of the box. So unfortunately, I've already been pre-warned yet, there's no plugs in this. They didn't have the final UK adapter and everything before they sent out the review samples. But we all know what a plug looks like, don't we, kiddies? And if you don't, that's what a plug looks like. So you get one of those in the box. Snapdragon 650 inside, so it's not quick charge 3.0, etc. unfortunately, but it should hopefully charge up quickly. We will of course be doing full battery tests and the rest to let you know all about that. Oh, so there you go. So it's already booted up into the desktop. So we've already skipped. They've clearly done the setup process at Sony HQ. So we're straight into the new Xperia X desktop. As you can see, the same sort of design as you get on the box, with the actual backgrounds. And the nice thing is that whichever model you get, the desktops will be matching as well. So you get the yellow model, you get some nice yellow backgrounds and everything. So it's all unified, it all fits in very nicely. It feels like one whole phone, the hardware and the software coming together like two slugs having sex or something. That's a lovely image, sorry. I've had a lot of coffee this morning. I'm going slightly crazy. So let's have a look at the Xperia X itself. So it's running full Android Marshmallow, of course, with Sony's usual overlay on the top of it. There's a few little changes for the likes of the Z5. So for instance, some little icon changes here and there. If we dive into here, you get all the usual Sony stuff. So of course you get full access to all the Google stuff and get a nice bit of Kobo Bucks there as well. You get, of course, Sony PlayStation. You'll get Sony, his own music service and all the rest of it as well. So that'll all be included in there. So as you can see, oh yep, good old Miss Garada, how we've missed her. She crops up on every single Sony phone and has done for the past 4 or 5 years, how far too long basically. Know that song pretty well. What else to say about it? So Snapdragon 650, 3 gigs of RAM, so it should run nice and smoothly. Certainly, as I say, we've had 24 full hours with it in Tokyo, so check out our 24-hour review if you haven't done already. But certainly seems to be a very smooth performer, as you'd hope for, Snapdragon 650. It's, you know, it's not top of the range, but it certainly does the job. If you dive in here, unfortunately, there's no small apps anymore. So still chased up Sony, see if we can find out exactly why the small apps isn't there, but hopefully that will be either an update or there'll be a further option somewhere to do a bit of multitasking. As you can see, notifications bar hasn't changed at all. That's still the same old Android one that we know and love. So on the front, you also have a 13 megapixel snapper here and a 23 megapixel snapper on the back, which is only ever so slightly raised. I don't know if you can see that, just a very slight indentation off the top. If we dive into the camera app, it's Sony's typical camera app. So as you can see, you just flick up and down to reach video, superior auto, full on manual mode with all of the usual controls. So that's good. So you can have a play with those if you want to get just the right shot. But to be honest, superior auto mode more than does the job. And it's a pretty fast snapper, as you can see as well. Tap away, get lots of different shots. And if we flick to the front facer, hey, there I am. Yes, I know, you can also switch with a flick. And there I am looking absolutely gorgeous. I was up rather late last night finishing off some work, so I probably need a bit of eyeliner or something, but never mind. So yeah, in a nutshell, that is the Sony Xperia X. And so yeah, sorry about that, there wasn't the official Sony stuff in the box, but that gives you an idea. Basically, it'll be an adapter. You'll get the USB cable and hopefully some headphones included in there as well. And then of course, all the documentation and everything. And if you've got any questions or comments or anything, just let us know below. We'll be doing the full review. We're gonna do a bunch of other content as well, speaker tests and the rest of it. So if there's anything in particular that you would like to see, just let us know, and we live to serve, don't we, obviously. So, yeah, thanks for watching, guys, and speak soon. Bye.